Notice again on this integral, we don't have any limits of integration. That makes this an indefinite integral. We will integrate and we'll put a plus c on the end and we'll be done. And like a lot of these integrals, a single step of rewriting or maybe just a bit of algebra can really help the process. If you don't notice that first step of algebra, it can really put you at a standstill. So in this particular problem, what we're allowed to do is split up a numerator into its pieces. That's just a basic rule of fractions. You could split up 5/4 into 3/4 plus 2/4. You can split up a numerator, but not a denominator. Now that we've split up this integral into two pieces, we can simplify, but maybe we're still not at a point here where we can comfortably integrate. So an optional step here is to rewrite this as 7x to the negative first power minus 2x to the negative 2 power. Now this term can be integrated pretty easily, but notice that if you try to use the power rule on this piece of the integral, you'll increase this power by 1 and you'll get a power of 0. That should tip you off that this integral is actually something a little bit different. So we need to recall that the derivative of a natural log of a function is 1 over x, and that tells us that the integral of 1 over x is the natural log of x. Now there is a detail in here. You'll notice that this x value is allowed to be negative, while we're not allowed to plug a negative value into a natural log. So the little detail that we can add in is that technically there are some absolute values here, and of course there's a plus c. We could of course rewrite this integral rule in this form as well, but either way I think we're ready to go back to the original problem and integrate. We know that the integral of x to the negative first power is just the natural log of x. So we'll pull the 7 outside and integrate. Then we'll pull this negative 2 out of this integral. We will add 1 to this power here, giving us x to the negative first power, and we have to divide by that power. Put a plus c on there, and we are almost finished. We should probably simplify this just a little bit. I think that this is a really great answer here. Note that the answer could also be written like this. I think I like this one the best, so I'm going to box that one up and call this problem finished.